I mean, if you really, really thought that that Grubhub ad was bad, oh boy, you hadn't seen anything yet. So hey, it's Harry Husky, and I wanted to talk about something that seems to be a reoccurring thing with advertising nowadays, most considerably the food delivery services. So most countries around the world would have the likes of Uber Eats, but if you were in the US, you may have the likes of DoorDash and Grubhub, obviously, as probably some of you may know about already. But if you are in the likes of the UK, we also have Uber Eats, we also have Just Eat, Deliveroo, Food Hub. Or if you are in Australia, then Just Eat would be Menulog. A little bit like how Burger King over there is Hungry Jack's for trademark reasons because somebody else beat them to it. What I'm basically trying to say is, these food delivery ads, regardless of country or location, seem to have this recurring theme of being uncomfortable to watch, annoying, irritating, or straight up cringy, as some people would probably like to use nowadays. So if you've been on the internet most of your life, or even if it's just during these absolutely trying times, you may be familiar with a certain Grubhub ad that has become a meme, pretty much one of the first of the year. But for those who haven't seen it, here it is.
Grubhub perks give you deals on the food you love. The kind of deals that make you boogie. Get the food you love with perks from Grub, what you love.
Now, if you found that cringy, annoying, uncomfortable, or hard to watch, I honestly can't blame you. I myself don't feel the same way as most people do towards it, and that's for one reason, because I feel like I have seen worse than this. I mean, to think, that ad could be a whole lot worse. At least none of the characters were doing Fortnite dances. Okay, using whatever green screen stock Fortnite stuff I could ever find, let me just show you how much worse this ad could have actually been.
Get the food you love with perks from Grub, what you love.
So yeah, I think that should be self-explanatory, really. But before I go into why I don't think this is the worst one I've ever seen, what do I personally think of it? If anything, the only thing that really annoys me about this ad is the music choice, the recorder sound. Yes, I know what the song is called, but I just don't like it. It just makes my ears hurt and it just infuriates me. I mean, the animation from what I'm seeing is actually pretty good. I don't know which animation studio actually made this, but if somebody does know about this, then please leave it in the comments below. But I bet they're probably just sat there and thinking, what in God's name have we created? I say this because of this ad for UK dating site Plenty More Fish.
Does anyone know where I can get a date online? My friends will do it and they have a real good time.
Plenty More Fish. PlentyMoreFish.com.
Now, off the top of the head, I can't remember the person who animated, but somebody managed to catch up with him and ask him what he actually thought of the ad. And this, keep in mind, this is the person who animated it. He hates it, even to this day. He absolutely hates what he has created. So, only God knows, at the moment in time, what the creators of the Grubhub ad are sitting there thinking about it. Now, going into my reasons for why I personally don't think this Grubhub ad is one of the worst commercials ever to exist, because from where I'm from, I feel like we have had stuff far worse than that. Yep, you heard me right. I personally think that we in the UK have had far worse ads than this. And this.
Grubhub perks give you deals on all the foods that make you want to wiggle.
Get deals you love on the food you love with Perks from Grubhub. Grub what you love.
And also this.
There has never been a better time to have a favorite food. With new Grubhub Plus, you get unlimited free delivery and cash back rewards for ordering noodles. And noodles. And noodles. And noodles. Grubhub Plus. Free delivery, cash back, and noodles.
So without further ado, let me introduce you to this ad from UK food delivery service Deliveroo.
Deliveroo! Chinese, KFC, Wagamama, Greek salad, no carbs before Marv's there, Karen. Pizza Express, Dave. Here's your Burger King, Dad. There we are. Bad guys, lads. And Coma, daring as ever, Dino.
Oh, buongiorno Italiano. Oh, prawn crackers.
All your family favourites, now on Deliveroo.
Who ordered wings?
Now, for quite some time, this ad really grinded the gears and made the blood boil of some of the general viewing public in Britain. And let's just break down the reasons why.
Deliveroo!
Okay, first of all, let's just point out just the fact that she just slams the door on him and just the way that he's standing there. He's probably just dying inside knowing that he's in this ad and knowing just what he's even going.
Chinese, KFC, Wagamama.
Yeah, I mean, because no one in the history of mankind, anything ever, says out loud what people have ordered with sheer delight and excitement just like that. And especially in the pitching and the tone that she is saying in. Yeah, like, no one ever does that. Who? Like, who in the history of mankind or the history of anything ever has ever read out a list of food restaurants like that? No one.
Greek salad, no carbs before Marv's there, Karen.
I mean, yeah, of course, Karen. Karen would have the salad.
Oh. Buongiorno Italiano! Oh, prawn crackers!
Well, okay, I guess that just happened out of nowhere. Now, if you want some perspective as to how much this irritated many of the general food public, many of them called for this ad to be banned. Yeah, that's how bad this is. And their wish was granted, the ad was banned. But not for their wishes and their reasonings why. The reason this ad got banned, because even though it stated it in the small print at the bottom, it fails to point out in any other way that you have to make separate orders for each individual restaurant and that they all can't be delivered at the same time. So let's say you order from the likes of Burger King, Wagamama, KFC, your Chinese, Greek. So all five of those would have to be delivered by five individual drivers at different times, not one driver at exactly the same time. So in the end, that's why the ad got banned. And the interesting thing about that, that's not the only Deliveroo ad to be banned. This one was also banned for this.
Order what you want, where you want, when you want.
Okay. Let's just hear that one more time.
Order what you want, where 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 you want.
No. No, you can't. I can't order where I am right now. And I never can. It's been years. So yeah, that ad was banned for making people think that you could order from absolutely anywhere in the UK, when in fact, that was not the case. It's more a case of what food delivery service the restaurant itself goes to. The only reason Deliveroo don't deliver where I am is because none of the restaurants have gone with Deliveroo as their food courier service. Moving away from Deliveroo, let's go on to the biggest one in the UK, Just Eat. Now in the UK, advertisers seem to do this thing where they have a go at doing a musical parody, and needless to say, they don't seem to do a very good job at it. Here's some examples of some of the worst ones.
I like the way you taste so fine, but most of all, I like the way you move. I like the way you move.
Saving money at confused.com. say ooh-ah!
If I'd have known for just 1 second she'd resit her test with me. Okay, now go! Watch that car door. Oh, don't turn around here. Ease your foot up off the floor.
Today we're talking about Halifax's range of tax-free cash ices.
Ice.
Let's kick it.
Oh, God, please, just make it stop. Make
so
it stop.
Tax-free ices, a great way for you to make the most of your savings.
ISA, baby.
You've never off the air!
By keeping...
But now you get what they're like over here. Let's have a look and see how Just Eat had a go at it. So it all started off with this one, which is a parody of I Need a Hero about Balti, which is actually pretty decent, I'll give it that.
I need a Balti!
One Balti lamb tikka then?
Yeah, but don't forget the mushroom fried rice.
Just Eat. Tap the app and get that mini fist pump feeling.
Well, I mean, that one was actually all right for what it was, until Chicken Madras came along.
I see you, baby!
Chicken Madras! Chicken Madras! Chicken Madras! Woo! You drive me crazy! Chicken Madras! Chicken Madras!
Chicken Madras.
Oh, yeah.
Are you sure? That's quite hot.
Just Eat.
I'll say.
Tap the app and get that mini fist pump feeling.
Let me just clarify one thing. The Fatboy Slim remix of Groove Armada's I See You Baby is one of my favourite songs of all time. And that just makes me want to sit in the corner with my headphones on, having that on repeat, and cry until the memory of that has gone away. Ugh. So I just thought, surely they can't get any worse than that. But thankfully, they didn't. As Just Eat managed to redeem themselves with a parody of Backstreet Boys' Rock Your Body, with one about chicken satay, which doesn't sound like it's going to be good at all, but seriously, just give it a listen.
Everybody, yeah, chicken satay,
yeah, king prawn chow.
Just Eat. Tap the app and get that mini fist pump feeling.
Oh my gosh, I'm back again.
Now, considering how bad a lot of musical parodies in the UK tend to be with advertising, not just Just Eat, that one I actually thought was pretty good. Now, over the last few years, Just Eat have released some questionable ads, needs to say to least, but probably the worst one they've ever done is... Shall we order a takeaway?
Did somebody say Just Eat?
No one said it. No
did
one.
Did somebody say just eat?
Ooh.
Have they gone? Have they gone? Oh God. That was awful. That was traumatic. And even worse, it continued on to their X Factor sponsorships.
Did somebody say Just Eat? Say
yay! Did somebody say Just Eat?
Just Eat? Did somebody say Just Eat?
Did somebody?
Ooh.
Did somebody say Just Eat?
Did somebody say Just Eat?
Did somebody say Just Eat?
Every time that ad comes on, I just sit in the corner begging for it to stop and start crying. Could anyone get me out of this nightmare? Actually...
Did somebody say Just Eat?
sick of this. Get those Just Eat fools on the line for me. We're gonna do this doggy style.
I'm gonna be straight up honest here. I love this ad.
Did somebody say Just Eat?
Me, get delivery like a G. See, hungry dogs gotta eat. I get mines every day, every week. Chicken wings to the crib, I'm sitting here.
Like, how the hell did they go from making easily one of the worst ads I've ever seen to roping Snoop Dogg into this to do something far, 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 far better? Not maybe even a million times better than what Just Eat ended up producing. And I'm not even gonna lie, this is an absolute banger.
Thank you, my man.
You're welcome, Snoop. You're very welcome. And reportedly, Snoop actually did write the lyrics to this song. Like, who else but Snoop could have saved Just Eat? And not only that, Just Eat actually paid Snoop a whopping £5.8 million to star in their ads and also write lyrics for the ads. And then roll on to December, Snoop also had something for Christmas.
Ain't nothing changed here. Getting sushi delivered by a reindeer. Most wonderful time of the year.
It's a Just Eat Anything vibe over here.
Warming up with a miso soup. Me so bossy and me so Snoop. Got my man Mr. Claus on the line. Let him know that it's Just Eat time. Happy holidays, it's a doggy dog Christmas. A lot of treats to complete on the wish list. Whatever the venue, hit up the menu.
Did somebody say Just Eat?
So all I have to say left about that is thank you, Snoop, for getting me out of that living nightmare. So with that, I think you now know why food delivery ads in general can be pretty terrible. Not just with Grubhubs, because that is just the obvious one and that's only been very recent, but this kind of thing has been going on for quite a few years, and as it may have shown, that it probably will go on for many more years to come. And that's pretty much it for this video, so... Actually, no it isn't, because during the filming of that video, there was one ad I completely forgot to talk about. So the ad in question is this one from UK service Hungry House, who was formerly a company of Hero Delivery based in Germany. Now, the ad is a supposed parody of the multi-award-winning Channel 4 show Gogglebox, which is a show where various households across the UK watch TV shows. It's basically that. Doesn't sound like much, but it has won a lot of awards, and it's turned the people who feature on it into celebrities. So there's a lot more to it than it actually sounds for those who aren't familiar with it. So this ad seems to have a go at parodying it, and I couldn't find a proper upload of this ad anywhere online, no matter how hard I looked or where I looked. But the only copy I was able to find was one filmed on a TV by a user called Bradders, and just take my word for it, this is literally the only copy I could ever find. So with that, let's just have a look at the ad.
Bones on my chow mein.
Yep.
Chow mein.
Yep.
Now that just screams so much. It screams annoying, irritating, grinding, a lot of things that all of these food delivery ads tend to be. And it didn't seem to do good for Hungry House, so much so that in February of 2018, Hungry House was sold to Just Eat. And in May of the same year, Hungry House ceased trading in the UK and all Hungry House customers were diverted to Just Eat. And that's pretty much it for this video, so thank you for watching and goodbye. Mwah.